Hi, I'm Rune Fogh. I work with making robots playful and engaging for kids. At the Center for Playware, we're exploring new kinds of interfaces that children can think and be creative with in ways that are intuitive for them. In this video, I will demonstrate one of our prototypes. This is the plate. It's a tangible user interface that makes it easy to control your own robots. These bricks here contain different behaviors and functionalities, and we can put them on the different sockets on the plate. Let's start by turning the plate on by attaching the on brick on this slot. To illustrate how the plate works, we need help from our friend the Bumblebee here. This robot is built from Dynamic Motors and Lego bricks, and it's the goal that you can build all kinds of different robots and still use the plate interface to program them in an easy and tangible way. So let's start programming our Bumblebee. These bricks contain different emotions or games that you can play with the robot. There is tickling, dancing, or being angry, or maybe follow me, or escape from me, going around looking for things, singing songs, and playing dead. Let's try to start tickling the robot. I really like that. We can also try to make it angry. Ah, now it will attack us when we get too close. Or we can make it dance when it hears sounds. As you can see, there are more slots up here, so I can give the robot multiple behaviors at once. Those are then prioritized using a subsumption architecture. So let's try to make the robot both angry but also tickling. So now it's really angry. But if I get close, it starts laughing. Or we can make it dance while singing a song. This really opens up for what you can build with the behaviors. The robot can also be controlled using this gamepad. You can move the head and run around. Then I can use this brick to record something by putting it on the record slot. Now whatever I do with the gamepad comes into this brick, and I can put it on the slot up here as a new behavior. Now this behavior will be looped in the robot. I can also teach the robot to do new tricks using this training brick. So when I put this on, I can use the gamepad to show the robot what I want it to do in different sensor situations. So for example, I want the head to go up when I pet it. So I show the robot what it should do. When I put my hand over it, it should put the head up. And now this behavior is inside this brick, and I can put it here and to see if it works. And it does! We've learned the robot a new trick. The training is utilized with a k-nearest neighbor algorithm. We can also combine different behaviors using the combined brick to make new behaviors. So putting the combined brick on the combined slot, tickle and follow, I can now use the gamepad. These five buttons here will correspond to the five slots here. So when I press one of the buttons and activate the sensors, the new brick will learn that this is the behavior I want at the certain sensor input. So for example, I want it to tickle when I go up here, and I want it to follow me when I'm down here. But maybe I want to be tickled here. So now that new behavior should be in the combined brick. Put it on to test it. Of Combining is also utilized using the k-nearest neighbor algorithm. The plate interface shows how we can use tangible interactions to control robots in a very child-friendly way, and still allow the children to customize and be creative with the technology.